Thanks, Nikki. Schools all over Western New York are now telling students to prepare to work from home. All new at 6 tonight, our senior reporter Eileen Buckley shows us how two schools are getting ready.
Inside this classroom at the Buffalo Science Charter Middle School, a teacher is helping students set up laptops. If their school closes, every student in grades 5th through 8th will take home a Chromebook.
Right now, the teachers have been preparing this week in the classroom, getting them all signed up on Google Classroom and the procedures of signing in, making sure that they're comfortable for the lessons and for distance learning.
Principal Kelly Wilczak says teachers have already trained for distant learning.
I think our students are comfortable. It's just the having that responsibility of having their Chromebook on their own.
Governor Cuomo announced school closings will be up to individual districts, not the state. But if a student or staff members test positive for COVID-19, a school must shut down for 24 hours. The governor has also waived the required 180 days for schools to be in session.
It's different. I guess I don't want to say I'm panicking or fearful, but it's giving me and all of us as administrators a lot to think about.
At Our Lady of Black Rock Catholic School in Buffalo, Principal Martha Eady says they're also preparing for a possible shutdown.
For here, we do have a contingency plan for student work that will be assembled by teachers. It'll be in the form of probably packets that will be sent home.
But the principal says, unfortunately, the school does not have iPads or laptops to send home with students. For now, the school nurse is keeping a close watch on student health, and her students are using hand sanitizer and following proper hygiene, reciting the Our Father to make sure they are washing their hands long enough. West Seneca Central Schools are also sending students home with educational materials, and the Williamsville School District says it's also prepared for online education if COVID-19 hits. Eileen Buckley, 7 Eyewitness News.